I honor and love you, but I shall obey God rather than you. And while I have life and strength, I shall never cease from the practice and teaching of philosophy. But whichever you do, I shall never alter my ways, never adjust my approach to this maze, never reform till the end of my days, even if I have to die many times.
God is apprehended by imagination, intuition, reason, such opinions as the name, and so on. But if by the other hand, we finally can begin to understand, so to some seems a shame to go on.
But he is all things in all, and he is nothing in any. He is often found in one thing small,
conversely he is often missed in many.
God endows us with sense and intellect. God endows us with reason we neglect. And despite the abolition by the current Inquisition of any intuition that they don't choose, when it comes to God, I find I can't believe that he designed a human being with a mind he's not supposed to use.
Rise up, man.
The wrath of God is natural. We are despicable.
If God by inaction had given man the stage,
if man's malefaction sends God into a rage,
we can hardly be aghast. That up we're raised,
that down we're cast.
That man should be sublime,
that God damns us for all time.
We are born to make manifest. There is no such thing as human nature, not in all or few men, since there is no God to conceive.
The glory of God we are born to make manifest. Our deepest fear is not that we are inadequate. Our deepest fear is that we are powerful beyond measure. It is our light, not our darkness, that most frightens us. But as we let our own light shine, we give permission for others to do the same. That is why we are, each of us, a child of God.